Grace is spiritual advantage that can be converted and committed as a fuel, what you call anointing. I call it fuel. Anointing is not feeling the tangible move of God coming upon your life. Amen. But anointing is pouring oil on the vehicle that still has to run for miles. Now, what is this? Spiritual advantage. In the midst of your educational, financial, social, economic disadvantage. The only advantage I've come to have in ministry is not education. The only advantage I've come to have to dwell in the place of my life is not money. I need money, but I don't have that as an advantage. I only have one advantage. And if I miss taking from God, I might not access the financial advantage that I want. I hear this.
Amen.
There is something that God wants to do in my life. It requires money. But I don't have a secret. I do not have a strategy of getting money. I don't. My only strategy is to get spiritual economy called grace. So that when somebody looks at me, for no reason they can favor me financially.
Hallelujah.
It might not be that somebody will look at you and favor you financially. But it might also be that somebody can look at you and call you for a job. Like you just for a job.
Hallelujah.
You are not hearing me. And you need spiritual advantage.
Amen.
Because you know you are not good enough in the world.
Hallelujah.
You are not going to talk back to me.
Amen.
There is somebody always more hardworking than you. There is somebody always more educated than you. There is somebody always more strategic. Somebody always, you know, more specialist, more analytic, more critical than you. There is somebody that can always extra mile than you. But you have one thing that you can do now. It is to get spiritual advantage. When we pray, we are not spending time transcending or exchanging time for nothing.
Amen.
We are busy making a heavenly exchange here. We are saying, God, exchange my disadvantage for something that when somebody looks at you, they say, there is nothing special about you, but how did you get what you got? And your answer becomes grace. What God wants to bring us to is repentance of grace. When I pray for grace.
Amen.
I know there's always a better preacher. There's always a gifted teacher. I always know that there's somebody more anointed. There's somebody more visionary. Somebody more prophetic. Somebody more apostolic than me. But there is one thing that I always go and get when I go to prayer. I go and get spiritual advantage. That when I say something and somebody says it better than me, I can still get the result more than them. Let me tell you, in this life, there are three things that you're going to get.
Uh-huh.
There are three things that you're going to get in this life. One, you're going to be a hard worker.
Yes, sir.
Amen. That gets less results.
Amen.
That's not what you want. You're going to be a hard worker that gets average results.
No.
Number three, you're going to be a hard worker that gets more results.
Hallelujah.
Productivity is when you've done, when you're getting more results.
Yes, sir.
Than the nature of your work.
Yeah.
So I want us to get spiritual advantage, grace.
Yes, sir.